loves, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new. Hi, hello, my name is Loey, and her name is Haley, and we became best friends because we initially spoke about Dear David on the internet.
Yeah.
Haley made a video called Dear David, and I noticed I had seen you before this, but up until that point, I hadn't like reached out to you. I hadn't really talked to you. I had never like mentioned you in a video. I knew who you were and I was aware of you because a lot of my followers had told me about you.
Oh.
But until that point, we didn't really know each other, like personally.
Yeah, like I know that I had started saying my loves at the beginning of my video, and that was like a really big deal to everybody. So I had a lot of comments saying that like you were gonna hate me or we were gonna hate each other.
Like anyone has a patent on a word.
Right, but it wasn't until I made the Dear David video and you wanted to cover the story that you reached out and you actually, I remember you put my little picture in the video.
I remember that too with your little like,
with your silver and pink hair.
It was so cute. It was literally the cutest.
Yeah, it was an era.
And that is the reason that we became friends. And now,
here we are.
Here we are. And you see the title, although I don't really know what I'm gonna title this. We found this album. We were literally filming a Get Ready With Me, which is probably coming pretty soon. And I was in my bathroom, or I was going to the bathroom to go curl my hair. I hadn't checked my phone in a few hours. I picked it up and the first thing that I saw was countless people texting me, tweeting me, emailing me that Dear David was going to become a movie.
A movie, which is, okay, you guys won't understand how big this is to us and our friendship. Yeah. Unless you know the fact that almost every day of this week, Loey's been saying that she's, one, very, very upset that there hasn't been a continuation of Dear David, not even for the sole purpose of the videos, but also because she was so invested in the story.
Yeah.
But also, she kept saying, I'm so surprised. Like, I just kept having this feeling that he was gonna come out and say, surprise, this is a movie now. And
it literally, I was saying that last night. Last night I said to you, I just think he's going to come out with a movie. I just think this is gonna happen. And
she really
I said that to you last night. And this is just an extra in a string of coincidences that we're gonna talk about in a video on Andrew's channel. There's like a glitch in the matrix or something. I don't know. Haley and I like do weird things when we're together. I swear to God. Every time that we're together, everything that comes out of our mouth comes true. So that's why we never say anything bad.
Yeah. Actually, we're purposely making it a point to say good things now.
Yeah. Because we realize that like literally we come together and the universe gives us everything. So it did give us a Dear David video, or a Dear David movie rather. This is a Dear David video though.
We were the original Dear David movie.
Oh, we really were. We were really out here producing the Dear David movie. I would have made that movie in 2 seconds. I wanted to conclude the series on my channel, and this feels so bittersweet and so final when I say it like that. I'm not crying, by the way, my eyes are just watering.
She's crying.
I'm just crying, I'm so sad. I guess this is really the end. This is really the end of this series on my channel, because I think that the next video will probably be when you cover the real movie. You know what I mean? Because Haley does this series on her channel.
Yeah, I never thought of that. The true story behind Dear David.
She's gonna probably be, I mean, unless like some more stuff comes out, her video will be the next and probably the last one, unless it continues to be covered online, because it's no longer going to be shared online. I mean, this started as a viral story. I never would have covered The Sun Vanished, Teletubbies Facts, any of those viral scary stories that I did if it wasn't for Dear David. And so it feels crazy to me that it's like, it's actually over.
It feels like the end of an era.
It really does.
Yeah, like it really feels like, you know, that like when Harry Potter ended.
Yeah, oh my God.
Except Harry Potter is like my,
yeah, no offense, Adam, but Harry Potter, like, Dear David's here, but Harry Potter's, like, right here, so.
But, you know, what I was just thinking, I don't know, like, you can read things on my face really easily. You can tell my emotions were going in my head.
Right.
Imagine that the reason the story hasn't continued is because now he's under contract, a contract, and contractually things could still be occurring, but they're saving it for the movie.
Right. No, I completely think that from here on out, he's probably under a contract. He probably can't talk about it. That's not to say that hopefully one day I won't have him on my channel, because I really hope one day he'll come on my channel.
I really hope you do too. Like, as a LoeyLane fan and as a LoeyLane soul sister, I really, really, really want that to happen so badly.
Haley knows how much I care about the story. Haley knows how emotionally invested I am in this story. And you guys also know that, but like in my day-to-day life, I talk about Dear David. In my day-to-day life at meet and greets, people were like, I found you because of Dear David. I fell in love with Dear David because of you, like, yada, yada, yada. And I'm not saying it was my story or our story by any regards, but we really did bring it to YouTube, and other great YouTubers covered it as well, but you were the first.
I was.
You were literally the first.
Isn't that wild to think? And yeah. Now it's like a motion picture. I knew I saw potential in it. The thing is, like, when I first found the Dear David thread, it was because a lot of my fans and my followers, I don't even like to call them fans, they're like family members.
I know, it's like
a lot of my family members, the Reese's Pieces, were sending me a whole bunch of tweets saying, Haley, have you seen this? Have you seen this? And I went ahead and I read it, and automatically I was like, this needs to be covered. This needs to be talked about. But at that time, Adam really didn't have a big platform. Now he's at over 1 million followers.
He's left his full-time job at BuzzFeed to work on his own stuff. And, you know, he does incredible art and stuff. But one of those huge projects was Dear David.
And you knew it all along.
It's crazy because I kept telling Haley over and over and over again, especially when the photos started coming out, when things started getting a little... Not
a little Hollywood.
Yeah, a little Hollywood. We'll go with that word. I was like, this is gonna turn into something. I can feel it from a mile away.
And like, in a way, I feel like Loey didn't want this to happen because she felt it was so real, so to speak. And that's not to say it isn't, that it wasn't a real experience. I'm just saying, for you personally, like, you felt like you wanted there to be a conclusion on his Twitter. You wanted this to just remain Twitter's little story.
Yeah, like Twitter's sweet little, like, alternate reality or real reality game. I wanted it to be the social media darling that it truly was. I mean, I loved this story so much. And you guys knew that. You guys called me out on it sometimes when I would tell you, you know, when I wouldn't call out certain things that seemed a little bit Hollywood. But at the end
of
the day,
I was saying, like, Loey, like, girl, these pictures are unbelievable.
As
it looks like
people,
a little doll.
Yeah.
And like, we agreed to disagree on how Hollywood those images were. And I think that's because you so desperately wanted to believe that this was just Twitter. This was just somebody sharing their experiences on Twitter.
And even though there were sometimes things that made me question it, I loved the story. And you have to think, at the end of the day, this is the first time we've ever seen a haunting unravel like this with such a large following. Like, Haley and I may tell you our hauntings the way that we do, but those are probably never going to become motion pictures. I mean, never
speak
say
for
never.
Yourself,
But I mean, it's just crazy to me to think we watched it totally unfold and now it's going to be a movie. I do think that this needed to be wrapped up, and I needed to kind of conclude my feelings and my thoughts on where Dear David is, because at the end of the day, I truly believe the story is over. I don't think we're getting any more tweets. I don't think we're getting any more story. So we are left with where everything left off. And I feel like it's kind
of just genius marketing.
Oh no, and it is.
We all want to know, how is this going to end in the movie? Right. We're all going to go and see it. Even if you know that it's, or you believe it's been fake this whole time, you want to know how this is going to end. So that's a very, very deep marketing ploy, and it's genius.
And I mean, Adam himself has said that people who worked on It and The Conjuring and like these incredible, incredible horror movies that you've talked about on your channel.
I'm so into like scary movies and the
I know, I love
and things
it.
Like that. But yeah, this is going to be what I presume a very, very big deal. And I believe that he should capitalize off the opportunity because
of course.
It's great. But at the exact same time, it's bittersweet for us who have seen this story just grow and grow and grow.
And we don't have the end. We don't have the end. We have to wait and see what Hollywood does with the end.
And that could be a great thing, or that they could completely tarnish what we all, which is my fear. I think, like, Dear David, no matter what your argument is, you know, we're on different spectrums as to the authenticity of the story. I'm in no position to tell people what's real or fake. I tell true stories people don't believe. But with that being said, you know, I am invested in the story itself. To me, it wasn't that serious whether it was real anymore.
Of course,
I just enjoyed the storyline. And really, I think Adam, regardless of whether it was true experiences or not, did a fabulous job at keeping people interested and hooked. And I really just hope that it's just as well done in the motion picture, because there is nothing worse than expecting so highly of something and having it underperform.
Agreed.
So I pray that it's like what we hope it is. We're probably going to have the biggest sleepover. And rave about it and talk about it and review it and stuff. But
a lot of people have actually like already gone to Adam's Instagram and told him to give us a cameo. So
I would love that.
That would be so funny. Like, see like these two little girls in their like
bedrooms.
We're like, hello, my like that would be
with
so
Haley's
funny.
Silver hair. And
oh my god,
background.
That would be so funny to me. That would be so funny. It's unreal.
I just think it's such a moment to think about how full circle this has come, and how a year ago I was covering the start of it. You really took it over. We were separate lives. We weren't soul sisters yet. We weren't, well, we always were, but we weren't friends yet. And to think here we are talking about the finale of it together.
It's like together in my apartment, like not even planning on talking about this today, just hanging out because we're actually best friends.
And so if anything, Adam, thank you for bringing
us together
and bringing everybody such entertainment over this time, because
I'm literally crying. Andrew's literally crying.
Seriously, it's wild though to think like it's what really brought us together. And so, you know, so many great things have came from this. And I hope that in this future endeavor of Dear David, it just continues to grow and give people the spooks and the chills that it has for us over the past year.
I thought that what could be really interesting to kind of conclude our coverage of Dear David for now is to talk about our theories on where everything is, where this story ends, so to speak, whether it's what we believe or whether it's what we like. Now, keeping in mind that the last of the tweets was kind of Adam, like he was just like filming his cats and like not saying anything, or he had no recollection of certain tweets that he posted. My initial reaction is that David has taken over. David has taken over Adam's body, is like living through him, is like doing all of this, which that would be such a meta moment. He like makes the Dear David movie, like what? But you know what I mean? Like in context of the story, it does seem like Adam became possessed by David. There was no conclusion after that.
You know what I mean? I really wish, if this is like a story, maybe it started out as original haunting, you really
put it.
I really wish he would have emphasized a little more on the wishes aspect of it. I feel like that really got lost along the way.
Yeah.
Like, what was that? What did it mean that he asked, or the question, the wish question?
Right.
Like, when he asked that question that he wasn't supposed to, that was one of the most chilling parts of the whole story, in my opinion.
Right.
And it would be interesting to see in the film, like, what the consequences of that were.
Yeah.
Is it that you now give him access to take over your body. I don't know, but I think that, I hope in the film that's something that they really play on, because I think that's what makes this so scary. And I would love, love, love for them to dig more into who David was with the being crushed in the supermarket. I feel like that's really been lost over the span of the whole story.
Yeah, no, I completely and totally agree. I feel like there were certain elements of this story that kind of got lost as it was revised and revised and revised, and that just happens.
Naturally,
you know,
yeah.
I another good example of this, I know you probably don't follow like super scary games very frequently, Haley, but Five Nights at Freddy's was a huge horror game franchise.
Oh, the little girl that babysat that was possessed, she played that game.
Oh god,
it was like the bears that pop up and stuff. On,
ew,
I swear.
Gross, I would die.
Yeah, I swear.
But the writer of that series, you know, he's revised and revised and revised and, you know, made things more clear, taken certain things away. It's kind of like that when you're writing a story in real time and you're not just releasing it fully made. I think revisions are going to be made, but I do hope that they touch on that, because I completely agree.
I want answers to that.
I do too, because one of the biggest things was that girl in his dream said to him, if you ask him a third question, he'll kill you, or something, you'll die, something along those lines. And what does that mean? Does it mean that, like, figuratively Adam is dead and David is in control? Does it mean that he's going to die? Does it mean that he's, like, slowly becoming less and less? You know, there were two different real big sides of this, from my fans anyways. It was either people who were like, David is completely taken over, or it's people who were like, Adam's going crazy. You know what I mean? Like, he's seeing things that aren't there. He's seeing this boy dangling above his bed, like so on and so forth, that he was going insane when he made those tweets. Like, did you see that, like, everything is fine out of nowhere?
You know what was funny about that? I literally quoted it and said, okay, David, but you did the same thing and I didn't know.
That is so funny.
We tweeted it at the exact same time and someone's like, okay, Loey. And I was like, wait, what? And I went over and we tweeted the same thing.
We're just forever copying each other. It's
we
fine.
Are.
We're
sorry,
just always
recycled content. Okay. What I think is interesting was the fact that near the beginning of the story, when I was still covering it, his cats would meow at the door.
Yeah.
And a lot of things, I have an itch on my nose, but that's okay. A lot of things were going on the outside of his apartment with the attic and all of that stuff. And what I found was an interesting theory was I believe that David was a demon because of the rules, and also because demonic things happen in threes. And there's like a three sequence of it, but also at the exact same time, demons need permission to enter. the fact that it was always at the door at around 3 a.m. that this was happening, I had a theory that David was waiting for the perfect opportunity to enter. But then when the picture surfaced, he had entered. You know, he was entering.
So maybe that's a missing piece of the puzzle that we're going to be given, is that we're probably giving like ideas to the writers of this movie, I swear. No, but like I think that I hope anyways that's something that they'll talk about. One of the biggest things that you pointed out was that Adam had bought a Ouija board and he never came back to it. So part of me wonders if he talked to David, thought this was just like a poor little boy, you know, like in the story of like Annabelle, like the like true story. Like maybe he gave it permission thinking this was just a little boy and feeling sorry for him.
I will never forget when he posted the tweet that he had bought the Ouija board. I just like felt such a disconnect from the story. It scared me like genuinely from the bottom of my heart. I think if you even have any suspicion that it's not even that it's demonic, but just that it's a dark entity in general, that is something you should steer clear from. So there's so many things. There's so many questions I have. In a way, I'm hoping they're answered in the film.
Right.
I think at the end, it's going to end with David somehow winning. I really see this being a David thing. I could even see it going on to be a series if it's successful.
Oh, no, 100%. I was thinking to myself that maybe David would win this time and then maybe he'd move into the next apartment and the next apartment and the next home and get it maybe even attached to something. Maybe he gets attached to that green rocking chair that everything keeps going back to, because there, that has been so significant throughout this entire story. The color green has been very, very, very significant through this entire story. And I'm curious to see if they'll expand on that, if there's just more explanation on that. One thing that you said with the cats meowing at the door, at the end of the story, so to speak, or at the end of what we've been given so far, the cats are meowing at the phone, at Adam. You know, so it's instead of it's outside, it's like they're meowing at him. Oh, I just got chills.
So now maybe perhaps he's become David.
Yeah. Part of me really thinks, and it's, I think, sorry, by the way, that the camera's going in and out. We're just like chatty Cathy's today. This is not like a super professional setup. My dirty kitchen behind me, we just were too excited. No, we didn't want to set up a ring light. And this is just taking it back to like the OG, like the chill freaking I was sitting on my floor, you know, kind of way that we would talk about this story. And I do think that's kind of creepy, and it's something that didn't really even occur to me until you just said that they were meowing at the door, and now they're literally meowing at Adam.
And everything is fine. And Adam went on a real hiatus for a while.
He really did. And I mean, I think now it's probably because it was right in the movie. But you know what I mean? Like, I do think other big questions. Do you have any other like huge things that haven't been answered yet that you can think of?
The thing that I found kind of strange about the photos was that like in different times that he was capturing him in the photos, it seemed as though David was changing in size. Did you ever notice that?
Like, no, I didn't.
Yeah, like in the one, I believe he was in the living room. They were the creepiest of all the photos to me, where he was like across from him in comparison to when he was on the bed while Adam was sleeping. Oh. I found like the sizing of the two, maybe I'm wrong, was a little bit different. So perhaps it could be a demon, so to speak, that can change its appearance, change its form, things like that. Maybe it chose to come as a little boy to, like you said, trick and be more appealing and gain sympathy from Adam.
Yeah, I think that that's very true. Something from like the movie production side of things that I didn't really think about is, you know, when it did take a turn and the doll, if that's what it is, was kind of incorporated in the photos, it was so lifelike and so creepy, and maybe it's a prop. You know what I mean? Like maybe it's something we're gonna see again in the movie.
I see. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
That's a theory.
That would be really interesting to me, and it would really keep things very coherent. But you know, we'll just see. We'll see where things kind of go with that.
We literally just found this out under an hour ago, and so this is kind of at a point for us where this is jumbled thoughts. This is a real raw, uncut version of our thoughts on this entire thing.
And our feelings, and our very real feelings. And I mean, it might seem silly to some of you to be bummed or to be sad or to be kind of emotional over the fact that something like this is coming to a close online. We are so, from the bottom of our hearts to Adam Ellis, thank you for everything. Thank you literally for letting us meet, for giving us this incredible, incredible story. But also, like, we are so excited. We are so proud of you and so excited that you wrote something that is so entertaining, that Hollywood
captivating.
That Hollywood wants to let you be a part of that. And I hope from the bottom of my heart that this is good. But no matter what, I'm so excited for Adam. I'm so excited to see where it goes.
And honestly, we are rooting for you and for dear David. And don't let us down with the ending, because we need it to be good.
We need that ending.
We need it to be good.
I am just, this is the craziest thing in the entire world, and I'm so excited. And thank you guys for listening to us ramble for close to 20 minutes about how much we love this internet story.
Thank you guys so much for enjoying it from day one and really getting invested and enjoying it as much as we have. It's been so fun watching Loey take over this story. It was so fun coming on and talking about Dear David while I did. And it's just been a really great year of like wondering what was going to happen next.
It's been an amazing year of being constantly on edge, wondering where this story was going to go. So I think that's where we're going to leave it. And I want to know what you guys think down below. Give us any of your theories, and I guess we'll see you when the movie comes out. We'll see you in like a day with another video, but I mean, this is it.
This is it.
All right, thank you guys for watching. Give me a thumbs up if you did enjoy. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Subscribe to my sister Haley's channel if you have not already. I love her so much. I love you guys, and I will see you in our next video.
Bye guys.